우리 마셔.
여기 가서 여기 가서 나와.
Stage, which is the using of a watery color to render it at time. We can use whatever color to render, as long as the color must be around 50% of toner value. We don't use yellow or orange to render, because if you use orange, can, but you have to mix with some brown color. Make sure it is 50% of color value first. Okay. Then right now, for you guys, I'm thinking to use. Monday I used purple, just this morning I used blue and green, and now I use
orange.
No, just now I said the one you use already, you still use orange. Who is it? Purple color. Okay, make sure your draw is big enough. The rendering stage is for you to cover the white color spot. And also to help you to control the value. Light area here, because of first of all the yellow color or the green color actually is very difficult to cover. You have to get a very opaque color, then you only can cover it. Why? Because the yellow is a bit transparent one. And of course, if the I didn't render it because of I want to control the saturation. The place that I render after that, it was slightly desaturate a bit one. So I'll render on the background and the drop shadow, like the shadow. Okay, so once it done already, something like this is considered done. Okay, then the next step, I will start from the shadow area. So the shadow, what color can you see from the shadow here? What's the color can you see from there? Orange. And then? Brown. And then? Green. Any other color?
Red.
Red, yes. Any other color? Okay, so just that's why I will use green color plus red or vermilion color also can. So I'll add it together, add more green to get the grayish color there. And so when I apply the time, normally I will apply it according to the stroke that I apply must be follow the form and structure of the apple. Then after that, I will start to add more and more green color. Start green. So you can see from these color changes are from the in the shadow area. I will keep on adding a lot of color here because of this is the color changes for the shadow area. Every single color that I apply also use stroke, but I use water to blend it. Okay, so the colors here is slightly, yes, you can see the color changes from the green and then comes to the orange or red or brown here already. But it's the color I'm keep on mixing like this. Okay, all is still opaque color. Then once I've done the shadow like this already, the next, which is I will draw the vibrant area or the light area. So for the light area, don't directly use the green color because the green color is very fluorescent color. I will need you guys to mix some yellow or orange to slightly desaturate the green color a bit. Thank you. And then, in between the color, once I paint here already, then I will realize that the color, in between the color, is the color, light, and the shadow mixed together only. Then you can, you will very easy to get the transition between the shadow and the light color. Stroke to blend it. Okay, so right now you can see the light and the shadow. The light area is vibrant, the shadow is desaturated. Okay. This is the while waiting for it to dry, I will continue to draw the drop shadow. The drop shadow I will use red and blue. And if not desaturate enough, it's very vibrant right now, mix with some green color to desaturate it. Then the drop shadow here actually got the gradient there. So I will get this darkest tone first, and after that I will add more and more red color. Okay, so once I get the shadow like this, it's enough already, then I have to draw the background. So for the background one, you have to directly use the red color, make sure it's opaque.
Thank you.
And then slowly, nearer to the foreground already, I can add some vermilion color. Then for the vibrant area there, I will directly use vermilion only. All the way is opaque color, so I won't make it watery. So it's okay that you just purposely leave, you leave some purple or the under layer color. And after that, I'll mix it with the drop shadow again. Slightly touch up the edge because the edge is too sharp already. I have to show the edge blur a bit. Then like this, the background concealer done already. Then right now, you can see, just now all the way I'm still using the biggest brush to draw. Right now I have to use a smaller brush, the medium brush to start to add the details for the apple, okay? So of course everything I will still start back, go back to the shadow there. Find the edge, make it nicely, add more color changes in it. Thank you. there's some blue color reflection. Most vibrant green again. Get the lightest color there. A lot of yellow. Now, got any question?
How far are you?
Mm-hmm.
How far are you?
How far?
Yeah.
How long left? For me? Soon. Okay, then before I go to the most detailed part, I have to add a core shadow for the drop shadow part. So until from just now, I didn't add any black color. So that's why if later on anyone dare to use black color, I will keep using black. Okay, so don't use black color today. Leave your black color at home. You have to draw the core drop shadow here because this darkest toner value is for you to separate the drop shadow and the apple. And then right now comes to the most important thing, one of the important things, which is the called the apple stalk. Okay? So the apple stalk, very easy. Just use for this one. Two strokes can done it. Okay, start with the darker stone first. Make sure the brush must enough dry. Must very dry. And then the stroke, the color must enough opaque. Okay. First stroke. Okay. Then wait. So no need to wait for it to dry because my color is enough dry already. And the next one. Lighters and the top. Done. Okay. Don't put don't spend more than 1 minute or more than 1 hour for that area because that one is just a stop. Okay. Then right now have to add the highlight. Comes to the highlight already. Finally. Okay. So my this semester apple drawing. It's done. I have drawn so many apples this week already. This is my third green apple right now. Okay, so first of all, I have to dot out all the highlight. This is the secondary highlight. And then some of the highlight is blue color one. Add more white. Then now do the brightest highlight. So. Forever, for each object only got one brightest highlight on it. Don't put everywhere also the brightest. If everywhere also the brightest highlights ends up, you just make it flat on it. Okay, have a need more white. Final. Ta-da! Okay, done. Okay, so I will hopefully everyone can do this. Okay?